Thank you. Hello, I'm Mark Dolan. Welcome to Balls of Steel. This is the show where a bunch of new comedians pull a variety of crazy and idiotic stunts that put their asses on the line in the name of entertainment. Tonight, we've got scenes like this.
What's the matter, mate? Come on in.
There's some of this.
I'm sure we've been here before.
I'll get you there.
You picked me up back there on my leg.
And there's a little bit of this.
It's free, you know.
Yes.
Enjoy. Wally.
So let's meet our first contender. Please welcome Olivia Lee. Olivia, welcome to Balls of Steel.
It's just wonderful to be here, Mark.
May I say you look sensational?
May I say you look average?
OK, good. We've got the compliments out of the way. What a relief. Yes. Now, Olivia, what have you been up to this week?
Well, this week I've been interviewing celebrities, but I've been interviewing them with this.
OK. That's a penis.
It is a penis. I prefer to call it my penis microphone. Okay. And I figured celebrities talk a lot of bollocks, so wondered if they wouldn't mind talking into a cock.
Oh, my God. These people, they work so hard to entertain the nation. Let's take a look.
Okay, a few questions to Channel 4. Oh, thank you. How are you?
Hi, I just went back from the States on Sunday.
You look fantastic.
Thank you.
On it. Tell me about the outfit.
Fucking dick.
Yeah. Do you like it?
No, I'm not. It's not for me.
Channel 4. Yeah. Are you looking forward to tonight?
Yes, I'm on.
Whoa. Gosh. You're used to hanging out with Cogs, though, aren't you?
Basically, he's a male gigolo, and I play one of his dates, and I'm covered from head to toe in mud and. Got this matted wig on and stuff. Takes me out in a gondola, throws me in the canal, scrubs me, and then I come out.
Did it hurt?
It did hurt, actually, wasn't it, for 14 hours?
A few words for Channel 4. Charlotte, there's an enormous crowd here to see you. Is it the biggest thing you've ever seen?
Stop it right now.
What? It's only a microphone.
No, it's really not a microphone, lady.
It's a special microphone.
I know, it might be your special microphone, but I don't want to be talking into something like that.
Okay.
Mario, this way!
Mario, this is a huge event. This is the biggest you've ever seen.
You know what? We have these in LA all the time, so it's kind of like. But it's nice to do it across the pond. Come on.
So you're
you just
used to
it. I wore my gold chains with me, you know what I'm saying?
Oh, they're great. They look fantastic. Have a great night.
Thank you. I'll see you later.
Do you like
what should we decide?
I just need to tell me about your outfit. Where is it from?
Richard James.
Yeah.
And I can't remember who the shirt's from.
Does it take long to choose it?
No.
No? How long does it take to get ready?
Well, am I talking to a cop?
It's all very exciting. Wonderful party going on.
It's a great party.
Yeah, it really is. I'm very excited to be doing it as well. So too.
Anything big coming up at the moment other than this?
I'm basically, no, we're doing a column with OK. Oh, sorry, with OK. My goodness. It's like, that's not a microphone.
It is.
Oh, well. OK.
Sorry, you look fantastic. Where's the outfit?
This is from Donald Trump. Your eyelashes are so long.
They're not real, are they?
And are you presenting the award tonight?
Yes, I'm presenting. I'm just seeing it.
Oh my God.
Oh, like
it's
it.
It's clean. Do you want it for later? Do you want it for later? It's good to see you back.
Thank you.
How's it going, playing?
So far, so good. We've played two, we've won two, and we've had sending off. We've had a streaker, and it's all going well so far.
How many games have you played?
Loads.
How many?
Loads.
How many shows?
It's bizarre because you seem such a nice girl.
I am a nice
girl. Why would you do something like that?
But you're bigger than this, John. You're bigger than that.
Is your mother watching?
I should have thought you'd be used to talking to dicks.
Well, I'd like to genuinely officially apologise to anyone offended by the sight of that prick. We didn't know John Leslie was in the clip. One of the great moments was when that woman from Big Brother, Michelle Bass, you kind of established it was a penis,
And she carried on talking, thinking it was a microphone. Obviously, my cock was not as thick as her.
It clearly wasn't. The ruthless acid tongue, but she's definitely got balls of steel. It's
indeed.
Olivia Lee.
Thank you very much.
Well done. Brilliant.
At the end of the show, we're going to need to select a winner, the person with tonight's biggest balls of steel. And that is where our studio audience comes in. They've each got a fancy keypad, and when we've seen all of tonight's contenders, I'll ask everyone to vote for their favourite. Whoever gets the most votes wins, and I will present the winner with the hugely coveted Balls of Steel trophy. It could not be simpler. My next guest lives in a world of his own, a world where he plays his own weird little games. Please welcome Nedge! Great to have you here, Nedge. Now, Nedge, tell me, what have you been up to this week?
I'm inventing a new sport this week, OK? It's an absolute winner.
Yeah, OK. So what is this sport called?
It's called urban sprinting, OK?
Mm-hmm.
All you need is your own security tag, yeah? You set off the shop alarm, and then you try and get away from the security guard.
Now, before we see this clip, I must legally say the following thing. Please do not attempt to copy, imitate, or even do an impression of the clip we're about to see. And if you see Nedge out and about, do not approach him or even attempt any form of conversation. Let's have a look.
Here's how you play urban sprinting. You find a shop with a security guard, you take your tag and set off the alarm. You ain't nicked nothing, but they'll still chase you. So leg it. When you get to the nearest burger bar, the clock stops. And that's how you play urban sprinting.
What's the matter, mate? Come on in. Chicken Royale and some fucking Diddy Donuts. Come, Faye. Cheeseburger and some fucking chicken nuggets. Whee! Fucking chicken nuggets.
Well, I can predict the beginning of a worrying social craze. Truly disturbing but very funny. First of all, a few things to pick up. That fat security guard, he would have caught you if he knew you were going to a burger bar.
Well, I did. I left a trail, like a Hansel and Gretel trail of nuggets and chips, but he didn't quite keep up.
He didn't bite, did he? Now, what happened at the end when you were pulled down by that bloke on the escalator?
Well, we found out after that guy was the head of security for that building, and he just quit 2 weeks before.
That is properly unlucky, isn't it? But did you get, like, duffed up properly or not?
I had a black eye for 4 days after, but I fucked him up. I mean, I'm glad you cut it. Smashed him to bits, Mark, you know what
Okay, well... I'll believe you. I'll believe you. We're standing behind this screen now with a knuckle duster. It's going to be like a scene from the Jerry Springer Show.
Bring him out.
I'll bring him out. I'll tell you what, you're smarting for a fight, and I don't blame you. You've got balls of steel. Ladies and gentlemen, Ned!
Thank you.
My next guest makes a habit of pissing people off. Please welcome the annoying devil. I'm loving your work, devil.
Nice to see you.
Hey, good to see you, sir.
So, annoying devil, welcome to the show.
Yes, thank you.
Tell us, what kind of unpleasantness have you been doing this week?
Well, Mark, if there's one thing I hate, it's everything.
Okay.
But if you were going to press me, it's got to be shopping. I hate shopkeepers. I hate shops. And most of all, I hate shoppers. Because they're all after something for nothing.
I see.
So I thought I'd give them it.
Let's take a look at the clip.
Bud. Just take a swig. New formula.
Is it?
Yeah. Do you like that?
No, I don't.
It's got horse piss in it. Excuse me, I'm very late for my train. Do you think you could...
No, I ain't got time, mate. I'm late for work.
Well, if you go to your left, then I'll be able to get through.
What's your game?
Well,
I just want to go
good.
Work.
Are you the daddy?
I'm the daddy, yeah.
Now, which way are you going? Seriously, stop messing about, because I've got to catch a train.
Look, mate, I just want to go work.
Yeah, so do I.
Where am I waiting? You go that way, I'll go this way.
Well, I'm trying to go. I'm trying to go straight ahead.
No,
neither am I. I don't want to play games with you.
Come on, fella,
that's enough. This is valuable wood.
Yeah,
stick it. Morning. Lovely, thank you so much.
Sorry.
Hey?
Oh, very nice. Sorry?
Why not?
Is that real?
Yes, of course that's real.
You ready? There you go. Sorry. Just one more, just one more. I'm sorry. I'll get me ball. There's no need to hit me. No. Long distance bounce. I just want to have a long distance bounce. Can I have one more? And then I'll go home. No, don't hit me. It just takes it to a whole new level. All I want is a bounce. Oh, yeah.
Well done.
Not bad, not bad.
I love the slightly older lady drinking your beer.
Yes. And she had a second swig.
Did she really? Brilliant stuff. Ladies and gentlemen, the annoying devil.
Thank you, Mark. Cheers.
OK, girls, hang on to your men, because my next guest is Tyler Zuki, the Bunny Boiler. Tyler. Okay, now, Tyler, can you explain to everyone what you've been up to?
Well, I thought it would be interesting to see what would happen if I came onto guys in front of their girlfriends.
I see. So the audience are very worried about this. You zero in on a happy heterosexual couple, yeah, and you flirt outrageously with the man just to upset the girl.
Yeah.
Okay, where did you cast your evil net this week?
Well, I went to Brighton Beach.
Let's have a look.
This week, I went looking for love at the beach and I met a gorgeous guy called Chris. Unfortunately, he's already dating someone called Renee. Luckily, I'm much better looking than she is. Here's what happened when I came onto him right in front of her.
Sorry, do you mind if I just leave my bag here?
No, it's
all right. Thank you. Are you from Brighton?
No,
London. No, same. Me too. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, just
yeah, just here for the day. Are you staying over the night?
We haven't made any plans yet. It's been a fabulous day.
It's lovely.
Quite a lot of guys from jumping off the piers. And the other one just jumped straight down.
Do you work out? You look like you do.
Yeah, I go to the gym.
Yeah.
Occasionally, yeah. Do a bit of riding.
So do I.
Do you?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Are you not a muscle man for a living?
Not a
bodybuilder.
No. No, just.
You're really strong.
Is there any way you can put a bit of cream on me?
No. No, I'm just asking, Chris.
No, I can't.
No. Oh. Why?
Are you chatting him up?
Am I chatting him up?
Yeah. So he's my boyfriend.
Yeah. No, I am chatting him up.
Yeah. Well, I'm his girlfriend, so I don't think that's really appropriate.
Do you mind, Chris?
Yeah, no, that's not appropriate.
Is it? No, it's not.
No.
I'll wait. Amelia, come on.
So you can't put any on my back?
No.
Sorry.
I don't think it's appropriate.
How about my front? So nice and cool.
Do you know?
No, I don't know her. I don't know at all. I don't know
her. Oh, that's so good.
Is there any way you can take a photo of me and Chris?
No.
Why?
Because he's my boyfriend. What? Why?
Can't you take a photo of us?
No.
Is he only allowed to be in photos with you?
Yes.
Yeah.
Allowed to go away, please.
She's very strict, isn't she? She's always this jealous and strict.
No. I'm not jealous.
The way she goes on, I would have thought she was your mother.
You can take some photos of me. Am I allowed to take my top off? On this beach.
Yeah, you can do what you like.
Oh, okay. Really?
I'm going.
You go away and leave me with Chris.
Can you just bog off? Can you piss off?
Renee, come on.
No, what do you mean, come on? You're not telling me. Just tell her to piss off.
No.
Just piss off.
Does she always resort to violence?
You tell her to piss off.
I don't know. You don't always resort to violence, do you?
No, you just tell her to piss off, please.
If you want, you can come back to my hotel. It's got a great bed. Nice and hard. Just how I like it.
I think you need to fuck off. Chris, I'm not putting up with this.
Come on, let's go then.
Chris, can I get a photo of your bum? Chris, let me get a photo of your bum. That is a great ass. Chris, I love you. Don't be so gay.
Do I know her? I don't know her. I wish I bloody did, though. We can confirm, by the way, that Renee and Chris are indeed still very much happily together, even though Chris probably does think about it from time to time. Were you a bit scared by Renee's reaction?
Yeah, she did threaten to beat me up, so that was...
It's a shame she didn't. We'd all love to have seen that, wouldn't we? Nothing personal, just girls fighting. It's brilliant. Yeah. Great work, Tyler. Thanks. Ladies and gentlemen, Tyler Szuki, the Bunny Boiler. If at first my next guest doesn't succeed, he'll try, and then piss the arse off you. It's Ross Lee, the world's worst.
What an entrance. So good to see you, mate. Good to see you.
Now, Ross, what have you been turning your hand to this week?
Well, you know, Mark, there's nothing more I like than talking to people, you know? So I thought, what better than to drive a London cab?
OK, now, how do you think it went?
Pretty terrible.
Let's have a look.
Well, another day, another dollar. But what am I going to do? Well, I'm going to join a noble group of people known as the London Cabbies, and they've been kind enough to give me a cab. I've got my driving app, I've got the car. Come on, let's go.
Howdy doody.
We're going to Cambridge Circus.
Of course we can. Cambridge Circus, here we come.
Are you sure this is the right way?
Yeah. It's just down here, then just left.
I think this is really going out of the way.
No, don't worry. You just sit back and relax, and I'll get you there. Enjoy me nice, refreshing little journey.
All right.
Now, though, I think I might have made a wrong turning.
You made about 5 wrong turnings, I think.
So where did you say we were going?
Cambridge Circus.
Cambridge Circus?
Yeah.
All right, yeah, I know where we're going.
You have taken me round in a circle. I don't believe it.
A circle?
I'm sure we've been here before.
Calm down,
calm down!
We'll get you there.
You picked me up back there a minute ago. What do you mean, calm down? We've gone round in a circle.
I don't think we have. I think this is definitely the way.
Is there any reason why we're going 20 miles an hour, Ron?
Well, I don't really want to have an accident, you see. Slowly but steady does it. Here we go. Hold on, we're going over a bump. Are you all right?
I'm fine. Just a little bit annoyed.
We've got another bump. Are you ready? You all right?
Yeah, fine.
Right,
Now then, I've just got to literally just pop it just round this corner. Here we go.
Are you going for a car wash?
See? You see that?
Fucking idiots just driven through a car wash.
Here we go. Cambridge Circus. Right, that'll be £12.99, please.
Cambridge Circus.
Yes, it is.
It's Islington.
Cambridge Circus.
It's not Cambridge Circus.
Yes, it is.
It's not Cambridge Circus.
Yes, it is.
It's not Cambridge Circus. Do you not know where you're going?
Yes, it is.
Listen, you know, I'm late. I'm running late. I've got this stupid taxi driver right now.
Just hold on. I don't think this taxi lark's working out for me, is it?
Could you hold on? I'm going to bring you right back. This guy, this, I'm going to deck this guy.
I don't think it's going to.
No, what do you mean? You're getting out? What are you doing? What are you doing? Come back here. Come back here now!
Great job. Great stuff there. Now, you love winding people up. You drove those people crazy. They're trying to get to work.
Yeah, well, we're all trying to get somewhere in life, aren't we?
Not only have you got access to a cab, but you've definitely got balls of steel. Ladies and gentlemen, Ross Lee, the world's worst cabbie! They've all got balls of steel, but who's got the biggest? Now, you've heard the saying, no pain, no gain. Well, that's true for our next guests. If they don't feel pain, I don't pay them. Please welcome Balls of Steel's very own crash test dummies. It's the Pain Men! Danger, danger. OK. Now, gentlemen, you are the Pain Men, and in the name of science, your job is to come on the show every week and experience pain in a variety of contexts for the education of our viewing audience. Is that right?
That's correct, Mark.
Very encouraging. Well, this week, I've decided to place you in one of the most dangerous and potentially painful environments on our planet. No, not a Friday night out in Cardiff. The office. Gentlemen, follow me. Danger, danger! OK, now, a potential source of danger in the office comes in the form, I'm told, of a filing cabinet. But I can't really see it myself, so, Pritchard, can you explain why?
Well, people keep important documents in there, don't they?
Yeah, and?
If you were to put your hand in there to pick them out, and then all of a sudden your fingers have got caught in the door.
OK, good stuff. Sounds interesting. What we would need to demonstrate for the viewers at home, as this is a sort of trial, would be a nice pair of chubby Welsh hands.
Just like these, Mark.
Ideal.
Pancho, guinea pig.
Take it away.
Get hands in here, Pancho.
Well, it's time to file some really important documents here.
OK, let's see what happens.
Hand up.
Remember, if you're watching at home, don't try this. Broken Pancho's hand and the filing cabinet. It's known in the business as the double.
You all right?
Are you all right, mate?
You all right?
I'm never going to be filing in that cabinet again.
I don't think so. That's office rage in the extreme. Tell me, give me a pain rating out of 10.
Oh, it was a good eat, Mark.
It definitely was. OK, well, I don't think... It was a harsh eat. I don't think we've seen enough. I think there are greater dangers in the office. Join me over here, gentlemen. OK, now, a potential source of danger in the office is dangerous stationery, including elastic bands. I can't see it myself. Pancho, what's the problem?
Well, you know, you could be having a bored day in the office and, you know, possibly wrap one round your head and it all goes wrong.
OK, maybe there's a chance that would happen. To demonstrate, what I'd like you both to do is put these elastic bands around your heads and each pull the other's elastic band, and the first person who lets go enters our final trial this evening. Take it away, lads.
May the force be with you, Pancho.
You too, Marshall.
Okay. Can I please don't do this at home or in the office or on the bus or anywhere? It's very annoying. Okay. There you go.
I got fucking sunburned as well.
You definitely did. Okay, Pancho, give me a pain rating out of 10.
That was a definite 8, but you pulled away first.
He definitely did. Pritchard, give me a pain rating out of 10.
Well, same as the little shit. 8.
Okay, well, I'm afraid that you failed that challenge. You're going to enter our final scientific experiment. Join me over here, please. Danger, danger! Okay, another potential threat while you're trying to get through the office day, apparently, is the stapler. Pancho, can you explain why?
Well, you might be having a really bad day in the office. Mm-hmm. Your boss has pissed you off, okay. So you feel like stapling your tongue to the desk.
All right. Well, as a service to our... Okay, well, as a service to our audience, we're going to ask Pancho to receive a staple through his tongue in an imaginary office accident. So let's make sure we establish that everyone's ready.
It's been a real bad day.
Now, let me just say, don't ever try this. I know you wouldn't, but please, please, please. Okay. I get the feeling.
I'm sweating.
I get the feeling that staple is going to be used on my arse later on tonight, ladies and gentlemen. Okay. Take it away.
It's been a bad day, Matthew, and it's time to go.
He said, I can't fucking think, which I think means 10 out of 10, which means the worst thing that can happen in an office situation is to get a staple through your tongue. Ladies and gentlemen, the Pain Man! They say Welsh people don't eat well, but that's a staple diet.
Fuck off.
Well done, lads. The Pain Man! We've now seen all of tonight's entries. One thing is certain, the coveted Balls of Steel crown must go to one of these contenders. They've all got balls, that's a given. That's why they're here in the first place. But the question is tonight, who had the biggest balls? The real Balls of Steel. Was it Olivia Lee and her prank TV? Nedge and his urban sprinting? Ross Lee, the world's worst cab driver? Tyler Zuki, the bunny boiler? The Annoying Devil. Or Pritchard and Pancho, the Pain Men. Studio audience, it's up to you to decide. You hold the key to these people's happiness and livelihood. Please choose wisely and fairly and press your buttons now. The votes are counted, the decision is in. I can now reveal that tonight's champion of Balls of Steel is... The Pain Man! Richard and Pancho, it gives me great pleasure to present you with this, the Balls of Steel trophy. Thank you for watching. Congratulations to the Pain Men. They all had balls of steel, and this is how they showed them.
Am I allowed to take my top off?
Yeah, you can do what you like.
Are we allowed?
get you there.
You beat me up back there 1 minute ago.